Okay, in this video we're going to talk about telescoping series. Telescoping series is a special type of series where when you write out the partial sums, you'll be able to see that all the terms cancel each other out except for a finite many, and then you can take the limit of the partial sums to see if the series converges or diverges. This problem is an example of a telescoping series, although it might not look like it at first. So let's just write xn as the sequence that's being summed in the series. So that's going to be 1 over 9n squared minus 3n minus 2. You can factor this as 1 over 3n minus 2 times 3n plus 1. And then you're going to do partial fraction decomposition. So to do that, you're going to say this equals a over 3n minus 2 plus b over 3n plus 1. When you simplify that, that's going to give you 3n plus 1 times a plus b times 3n minus 2 over 3n minus 2 times 3n plus 1. Then you can just worry about the numerator, so that's going to give you 1 equals a times 3n plus 1 plus b times 3n minus 2. And then you want to find a and b by plugging in terms of n that will cancel out a and then cancel out b. So to cancel out a first, we're going to want 3 in the denominator and then negative 1. So if we plug in negative 1 third for n, that will give us 1 equals a times 3 times negative 1 third plus 1, which will give you just 0, plus b times 3 times negative 1 third minus 2. So that's going to give you 1 equals 0 plus b times negative 1 minus 2. So that's negative 3b equals 1. So b equals negative 1 third. Next, we want to cancel out the b portion. So when we do that, 3 in the denominator again and 2 up top. And that will give you 1 equals a times 3 times 2 thirds plus 1 plus b times 3 times 2 thirds minus 2. So that will give you 0 here, and 3a equals 1 on the other side. So that will give you a equals 1 third. Now let's rewrite xn as the partial fractions. So let's pull out the 1 third for both. So we have 1 over 3n minus 2, and it was minus 1 third, so we pulled that out already, times 3n plus 1. And now that we've rewritten it, we do see that it does look like it is a telescoping series. Write out a couple terms of the partial sums to see that the terms do cancel. So when n equals 1, we have 1 over 3 minus 2, which is 1, minus 1 over 3 plus 1, which is 4, plus when n equals 2, we have 1 over 6 minus 2, that's 4, minus 1 over 6 plus 1, that's 7, plus, let's just do one more, 1 over 3 times 3 is 9 minus 2, that's 7, minus, and you get the idea. So the last term in the partial sums will be the pair 1 over 3n minus 2 minus 1 over 3n plus 1. And that's all the terms of the series. As we can see, the pattern kind of forming is that the consecutive terms start canceling. It won't always be the consecutive terms, but in this case it is. So we will cancel out everything except the first part of the term and the last part. That will equal 1 third times 1 minus 1 over 3n plus 1. If we take the limit of the last remaining terms, we'll be finding the limit of the series. So we take the limit of the partial sums to infinity, and that's going to be the limit of all of this, which when we simplify is going to give us just 1 third. So since 1 third is a real number, we've proved that the series does converge, and it converges to the sum of 1 third. And we're done.